Hi everyone, I'm Cheryl and welcome to the Sewing Room channel. Well, this is your tip of the week and I'm going to talk again about plaid fabrics. Remember in the previous week we talked about plaids. I showed you how to match your plaids together when making a variety of sewing projects, recommended a particular type of seam. Well, now I'm going to show you things that you can make that have very little sewing involved, just a straight stitch. So let's look at some more of this fabric. This is specifically Joann's Platitudes line of fabric. And I love this fabric. It's polyester, it's washable, really easy to sew with. It's warm, it's great to make winter clothing. So here's a couple that I haven't cut into yet. And this is my favorite. I love this one because it'll go with anything. But I thought this was specifically great for the winter time. So let me show you the table runner that I started in the last video. I'm gonna show you what I did with it. So in the table runner I made last time, I showed you how I matched up these seams. And if you'll notice, these sections have a specific width, and this section I wanted to repeat and make it exactly the same where the seam is so it's not noticeable. So I showed you the technique you need to go through to get all that matched up. Now let's take a look at what I did on the edge of my table runner. I did this fringe technique, and in a moment I'm going to show you how I do that. But this table runner, I just loved it. I bought the fabric specifically in mind to make a table runner for the winter and to use during the Christmas holiday because I just love that kind of old-fashioned being up in a mountain resort feel. That's what I thought it looked like. Well, let me show you some other items that you can make using this Platitudes fabric. This is just a simple rectangle, and you can use this to make something to put under a vase to protect your table or a lamp. You can even make placemats out of the Platitude fabrics. Remember, it's washable. So what I did to prepare this fabric to make the fringe was I made 1-inch wide fringe. I went in 1 inch and stitched a straight line of stitching around all four sides, and then I made the fringe. I'll show you that in a moment. Now let's take a look at one more. This is just a small accent pillow, and what I did was I cut 2 pieces of the Platitudes fabric, same size. I even matched the plaid so that it goes from one side, rolls around to the other side. I brought them together, and by the way, what I like about Platitudes fabric is it looks the same on the back as it does on the front, so there's no difference. I put the 2 pieces together, and if you want 1-inch frim, go in 1 inch and around all 4 sides, stitch it together. Leave a small opening, insert your polyfill stuffing, and then finish stitching it up. And then you go about making the fringe. So let me demonstrate how you make the fringe. This is just a piece of scrap fabric that was left over. And all you do is you take a straight pin, and starting at one end, you just pull it out like that, and then pull it out. Now at first you'll get just a lot of little small pieces, especially if your edges are not really straight. So you just keep pulling it out till you get some more. Now, I don't like pulling out more than 2 at a time, if at all possible, because it starts to jam up like this, because I have 3. So what I did was I'm just gonna go back to just maybe 2 and pull it out. Once you get all those little short pieces out that are along the edge, it goes really fast. Now on the table runner, I had a seam in the middle. So what I did was I only pulled it out up to that seam, did that whole side, then went over to the other end and pulled out the threads on the other side. Now you saw all of the projects I made. It was all out of the same fabric. So I want to show you what I pulled out. Look at that. Now if you're thinking, oh, that's a lot of threads to just throw away, you don't want to throw this away. One of my viewers gave me a great idea, was that she kept all of her little tiny pieces of scrap fabric that most people wouldn't even consider keeping, and she uses it as stuffing in dog beds that she makes. She makes a lot of them for rescue animals and all of that. You can even use this for that. Use it as stuffing. Other viewers I have like to use their little tiny scraps and threads for putting out in the yard for the birds to create nests. So don't think that you're going to just be wasting things. You can keep it when you get enough. Use it as stuffing. Isn't this pretty? This is a poncho that I made last year using the Platitudes fabric. You know the seam I showed you in the tip of the week last week? That's the seam that I used in this poncho. It's a very easy to seam to do that particular seam. Also, the fringe is here. Now in that video, I didn't show people to stitch around the a 1 inch from the edge, because this isn't something I'm gonna really wash all that much, or I'm gonna put it on a gentle cycle. But if you feel better and you wanna stitch around the edge, there's nothing wrong with doing that. So you could go in if you wanna do a 1 inch, 1.5 inch wide fringe, whatever you wanna do. And this is sort of almost a one size fits most. This makes a great gift because you don't have to worry about measuring people. So it's really nice, really simple to make, and very functional. I hope you enjoyed this tip of the week and that you're inspired to work more with the Joann's Platitude fabrics. I use it all the time, really simple to work with. Now, if you're interested in other projects for beginners, look below your YouTube screen for those video links. And also, the link to the poncho tutorial will also be listed down there. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram and check out my Facebook page. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time, and happy sewing. If you like the Sewing Room Channel, one of the best ways to show your support is to subscribe by clicking on that red subscribe button and give this video a thumbs up. And don't forget to click on share to share this video with your friends. And make sure you click on the bell so you receive notifications for all my new videos. I'm Cheryl, this is Manny, and this is Scotty. See you next time.